Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst of Chatterbox Quilts. I'm going to show you how to cut appliques from quilt batting using your ScanNCut. So you're going to need some quilt batting, obviously, and I like to use more natural, just 100% cotton. If you want to use a cotton poly blend, that would be fine as well. So just take your batting, cut it into a 12-inch square, and you'll be almost ready to go. I say almost because batting is a little flimsy, and you want to give it a little more stiffness before you use it in the ScanNCut. So what I like to do is to just spray it with some speed starch, whatever kind of spray starch you may have at home. So I just spray over the batting, and I'll usually fold it in half and press it down so it'll really saturate into the batting. And then I will iron it, and I usually will put a piece of fabric over the batting when I iron it, because the batting can kind of stick when it's got the spray starch on it to the iron. So to avoid that, just put a piece of fabric over top, preferably something that needs ironing at the same time. You can accomplish two things. I also will turn the batting over on the back, spray it again, fold it, press it down to saturate it, and again, press it. So it gives it just a little more stiffness, and that helps when it goes through the ScanNCut. What I'm going to be using for my mat is my standard mat, the one that has the purple along the bottom. So that's the one you want to use. Now this is a brand new mat. It looks great. It's not going to look so great after I put the batting on it. So if you have an older mat, such as this one, that has had quite a bit of use, I would suggest you use that one because the batting will leave a little bit of fluff on the mat. What I do afterwards to clean that off is to just spray it with some rubbing alcohol and use a baby wipe to go over it, and that'll take off that fuzziness. And I suggest you do it sooner than later because it's easier to clean it off when it's still fresh on the mat. So what you're going to do is you're going to just take your batting and you're just going to press it down, just use your hands to smooth it down just like you would for fabric onto your mat. The next thing I want to show you is how I'm going to create three different snowflake sizes using the preloaded designs in the ScanNCut. So on the ScanNCut now, I want to work with some of the preloaded designs. So we're going to go into pattern, and I want to choose the icon right in the middle near the top there that has the present and the flower. And then we're going to choose one on the bottom left that has the jack-o'-lantern and the present. And now I want to pick the very first one, which is this red sort of a snowflake design. And I'll click OK. So it shows me that this is just one piece to this particular design. Some of them have several, this one's just one. So just click OK. Now I want to make three snowflakes. So I'm going to push the plus button until I get to three and then click Set. And you can see that there are three snowflakes on my virtual mat. Move them apart a little bit here. All right, so I want to make them different sizes. So I'm going to click one of them, the one in the top left corner right now, and push the icon at the very top. This will allow me to go in and change the size. Now I'm going to click the one that has the arrows going up and from the right and left. And you can see now that it tells me it's 3.8 inches high and it's 3.94 inches wide. I want to make it bigger. So let's push the addition key. Uh-oh, I can't go any higher than that. Why is that? Well, very simply because the snowflake is already pushed up in the top left corner as far as it can go. It has no way to expand any further. So what I'm going to do is move another snowflake out of the way and move this one down a little bit and over towards the center. That way I can continue making it larger. Let's go up to, say, 5 inches. One more. 5 inches. Okay, that looks good. And I'm going to move him back up to that corner. Let's take the next little guy, and I'm going to move him over here, and I'm going to make him a larger size. You can see he is surrounded by a red square, and that tells me which snowflake I'm working on. Let's go up to, say, maybe 4.5 might be a good size. So you kind of have to play with these numbers back and forth. Okay, 4.5 is good. Now let's select the last snowflake, and we're going to make him, let's say, 4 inches. It's very sensitive, as you can see, and it gets a bit noisy. You can turn the sound off if you want. So when you're doing things like that, like I am doing right now, I should say, you might want to turn the sound off if you find it annoying. Okay, so now I've got them all where I want them. So let's click OK, or I should say the size I want them. Now I can move them around a little bit if I want to make better use of my space. You might want to keep a good distance around these because you're using quilt batting, and it is a little bit different than cutting with fabric. So don't push them right up next to each other. You're going to have problems with the cutter being able to distinguish between the shapes there. Once we think we're all set, we're going to click OK again, and then you're ready to load your mat and cut. Now that we've got the snowflakes the size we want, we're ready to cut them out of the batting. So I'm going to load up my mat. You can see that my batting is all nice and adhered to that. Oh, and one thing I should tell you, you want to change the settings on your machine just a little bit when you're cutting this. So I've actually changed the blade depth to about 6.5, somewhere between 6.5 and 7 is good, and the pressure is at 8 on it. So you're going to have to change the settings for this because it's thicker than fabric. Just leave a note for yourself to change the settings back afterwards or you're going to have some problems. Okay, so here we go. Okay, now I can unload my mat and see how it did. You might find that there are still a few little parts that are not quite cut all the way through, so you might have to take some little snips to get them off. But you can just pull it off. I don't even need to use my little spatula, this is coming right off. Okay, so this is what the ScanNCut cut for me. I've got 3 different sizes of the snowflakes in the batting. They look quite nice, did a good job on them, and now I'm ready to use them in a wall hanging.